Climate change is a threat multiplier. It makes communities that are already vulnerable even more vulnerable. With warming temperatures here in the Gulf of Maine, we're seeing impacts on species distribution. We're seeing an impact on the presence of kelp beds that are diminishing because of climate change.
We're seeing major changes and major shifts in climate, and there's a lot of uses for seaweed that are much more sustainable than anything else out there.
Seaweed aquaculture is the cultivation of kelp or seaweed in the marine environment maintained by an aquaculturalist or a farmer that is going out on the water, taking care and tending their crop every day.
Well, you don't have to put any chemicals, no food, no fertilizer, no treatments of any kind, no fresh water either, no arable land is used. I mean, the benefits of this type of aquaculture are giant for everybody and the ocean for sure. One pretty exciting and often talked about aspect of seaweed farming is that it sucks carbon out of the water. Kelp needs that carbon to grow, and as farmers, when we remove that kelp out of the water, we're removing that carbon out of the water and leaving that local ecosystem less acidic.
A lot of the source tissue for the nurseries is coming from wild sources of kelp, and it would be great to see the life cycle for kelp fully developed into the laboratory setting. One, to alleviate pressure off of wild kelp beds, but it also would produce a more reliable product for the industry instead of having to rely on some of these wild sources that you don't know if they're going to be there from year to year. Having a reliable market is really critical for a newly developing industry like we have here in Maine. Seems to be a lot of interest here in Maine of developing sort of more innovative products for the entire kelp industry.
What's really exciting in the next 10 years as the market scales up is you can also extract a lot of very interesting biocompounds from seaweed. Seaweed can be used for things like bioplastics, all different types of biomaterials, as well as used in cosmetics industry and pharmaceuticals, and the list goes on.
It can be used in biomaterials, bioplastics. It can be used in fabrics. It's a great food additive. It's a great food replacement, you know, for other products that are out there. It's carbon negative. It removes nitrogen. It makes the ecosystem better. So anything you're replacing it with on the plate, it's better than.
We know that there's all different types of destructive issues related to most land-based agriculture. So seaweed, it acts as a substitution for some more carbon-intensive areas.
Coastal and deserted communities are the ones that feel climate change most acutely earliest. And we have to find new ways to feed our people because our planet is getting less and less healthy. We need to be relying on aquaculture to build something that's additive rather than extractive from the natural environment.
I think I'm seeing changes in awareness of seaweed, and we've seen some publicity over here recently in New Zealand. And I hope that one day the kids that are watching this sector develop will be participants, and the ones that are working on the farms, producing the products, marketing the products. So that's the most exciting thing, I think, for me.